हेलो, मैं सिर्फ डॉक्टर दिनेश पाटिल। वेलकम टू माय चैनल डिजिटल फॉरेंसिक्स फॉर बिगिनर्स। इन दिस वीडियो विच इज टाइटल्ड एज लिनक्स बेस्ड वेब ब्राउजर फॉरेंसिक्स, द फॉरेंसिक इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ द वेरियस लॉग फाइल्स ऑफ द वेरियस वेब ब्राउजर्स इंस्टॉल्ड ऑन द लिनक्स बेस्ड कंप्यूटर सिस्टम्स आर डिस्कस। द यूजर्स इन ऑर्डर टू परफॉर्म और इन ऑर्डर टू एक्सेस द इंटरनेट फैसिलिटी used to install the web browsers. Now generally the user generally don't install only one type of web browsers. They will install many or different types of web browser depending on the functionality that is suitable for them. So whenever a particular web browser is installed on a particular system, computer system, the log files are created and stored onto the hard disk of the computer system. Therefore, it is essential for the digital forensic investigator to investigate those log files, and from that the particular forensic investigator so can identify what kind of user activity have been performed by the users on the system while using the web browsers. So to begin with, we'll understand why the digital forensic investigations of the web browser is important. The nowadays, as we are aware of that, the internet is being widely used not just at the industry purpose but at also at the household purpose. Now this internet facility is being used also on the mobile devices, not just apart from the computers or the laptop device. So the digital forensics investigation of the web browser is performed to identify, collect and analyze the evidence of suspicious activities of the users. Now in order to access the internet facility, the user install the various types of web browsers. So now by performing the digital forensic investigation of the web browser log files, so a particular forensic investigator can identify the evidence about the user's activity. This particular user activity may be a malicious or not a malicious activity. So the evidence of that activity is maintained in the various log files associated with that particular web browser. So what kind of informations that are maintained in the particular log files of the various web browser? So the information such as history, that means which particular website have been visited, the its URL, it is uniform resource locator, so that information is going to be maintained in the log files, the cookies which are downloaded. So when a particular website is downloaded at our computer or at our system, so along with that the cookies are also downloaded. It depends on the setting of the website. If they require the cookies for giving the better performance of that particular website, so they are setting the cookies, and that cookies they are coming they are getting downloaded at along with the websites, and they are stored on the hard disk. So what these cookies does, they collect or gather the information about the activities that have been performed by the user on the website. So the activity may be what kind of web pages which have been visited by the particular user, or what particular item have been purchased or that have been added to the cart. So those kinds of information are maintained in the cookies. So that is also maintained for maintaining the state. Okay, so that means whatever the state, let's say after some time from one page to another page the user is moving, so even in that case also the whatever the goods that have been purchased by a particular user, the state of that has to be maintained. So the cookies helps in that. Then also from this particular the log files, we can get the information about the list of the downloaded files, whatever the particular application or maybe any program or any document that have been downloaded by a particular user while using the web browser. So those details are also maintained in the download list. Then the cache is something related to the directories. Okay, so this particular information is also available in the log files. That means whenever particular some website or web page is required frequently, so instead of, or even certain website may not change frequently, So in that case, those websites are maintained at the cache. So instead of visiting to the server, web server, so those websites are served from the cache itself, so that it reduces the time of the particular user in order to access that particular website. But if a particular website is changing frequently, and then there is no usefulness of storing that particular website at the in the cache directory. So these kinds of informations are maintained in the log files of the particular web browsers. So a particular user does not access a particular does not use only one kind of web browsers. So depending on the functionality required, a particular user may install more than one browsers or more than one web browsers on his computer system. So in that case, there is a need of performing the forensic investigations of the various log files associated with all or the multiple web browsers, so that the forensic investigator can gain some digital evidence from those log files. Now, where are these particular log files are stored in case of Linux based computer system? So in case of Linux based system, I performed the experimentation on the web browsers like a Firefox, Google Chrome, Opera and VLD, and identified the particular log files associated with these particular web browsers and where they are stored on the hard disk of the Linux based computer system. So URL, that is the history file of the Firefox, they are maintained in a database called as a places.sqlite. So in this particular database, all the URL that have been visited by the user while using the Firefox web browser, so that information is maintained in the places.sqlite database. The cookies are maintained in the cookies.sqlite file. So whatever the cookies that have been downloaded while using the web browser Firefox, so that information is maintained in the cookies.sqlite file. And the cache directory, that means what are the URLs or the website that have been visited and which can be served from the particular from the computer itself, from within the cache directory. So that is available at the cache too. So instead of visiting to the web browser, the particular user is served that particular website from the cache directory itself, so that it reduces the time of the user in accessing that particular websites. So the location of all these historical files, that is a places.sqlite, cookies.sqlite and the cache too, is available in this particular directory. That is where the root directory, we can have the .mozilla subdirectory, then we can have the Firefox, then we can have this particular directory, subdirectory. So it will vary, this particular fn253 fn8.default, it will vary with respect to the system. Then we can have the another kind of web browser like a Google Chrome. It also maintains the URL related history in the history.sqlite file in the SQLite database, and cookies are maintained in the cookies.sqlite. Now from the cookies, what kind of information we can access? So from the cookies, we can access the URLs that have been visited. That means the cookie specify, it is some kind of a small code. Cookies is some kind of a small code, and it maintains the URL for which that particular cookie is associated. So from that we can also understand or get the ideas which URL have been visited by the particular user. Then the cache related information, that means the particular URL, the website which are required to be served from the computer system, they are maintained in the cache. So that details is available in the cache directory. And this particular Google Chrome related historical files are available in this particular directory. Then we are having the Opera. Opera is having the URL history file, and the URL history is available in the global_history.dat file. This is a particular file, which is a text file, and that text file maintains the information about the particular URL which have been visited by the user while using the web browser, that is Opera. Cookies for that, again this is a text file, and this maintains the cookies related information. Cache directory is available in the cache. So the location for the Opera web browser where all this struggle file is available is in the this /root/.opera, where we will be finding out these historical files. Then Vivaldi, like what we are in Google Chrome, so it is also having the same name for the URL history file, cookies file and the cache directory, and the location for this is going to be the home /vivaldi/default. So in this particular location you will be finding out these particular historical files. Now we'll discuss about the places.sql database. Now this is one of the important database in the Firefox which maintain the historical URLs. That means what are the uniform resource locator or have been visited by the particular or the website that have been visited by a user while using the Firefox web browser. The places.sql database maintains various kinds of tables. What kind of tables are they? Like moz_history_visits, moz_keywords, moz_host, places, then input history. So these are the various types of tables which are created and stored in this particular places.sql database. So one by one we'll see what are going to be the content in each of this table. In the history visits tables, a particular entry will be created each time a particular web page is visited. When a particular web page is visited by a user while using the Firefox web browser, the entry is going to be made in the history visit table. The keyword, this particular table, that is moz_keywords, it maintains the list of the keyword which have been used in order to search while searching the information on the internet by using the Firefox web browser. So that means whenever some keywords have been used in order to search for some resource on the internet, so that details is being maintained in the keywords moz_keyword table. Then moz_host, so what are the IP address of the particular host that have been visited by the user is maintained in the moz_host table. And the places, so it maintains the URL which have been visited by the this while using this particular web browser. And this particular table, that is moz_places, is maintained by the history service, and it also maintains the long term download history. That means for maybe more than a month or more than 6 months or year, what are the files have been downloaded by a particular user, so that are maintained in this particular moz_places table. And moz_input_history, this particular table maintains the history of the URL which have been typed on the particular web browser, that is a Firefox. Then we are having another history.sql database that is associated with the Google Chrome and the Vivaldi. Now the tables for all which are maintained in this history.sql is same for both the web browser, that is Google Chrome and the Vivaldi. What kind of tables are there? Like downloads, URL, keyword search terms and the widget. So these are the tables which are maintained or created in the history.sql database. So the names of the tables for the Google Chrome and Vivaldi are same for the history.sql database. So downloads is one of the table. It maintains the tracks of all the files which have been downloaded. So what are the files that have been downloaded by using those Google Chrome or the Vivaldi, and so that information is maintained in the downloads table. Then we are having the URLs, so it certainly maintains the information about the URLs that have been visited by the particular user while using the Google Chrome or the Vivaldi web browser. Then the search, the keyword that have been searched on the web browser, so that is going to be maintained in the keyword_search_term table. Widgets table, this maintains the information about the website which are visited by the user, so that is maintained in the widgets. And then there is another kind of the web browser, Opera. As I discussed earlier on, it maintains the various table like global_history.dat, search for field history dat, typed_history.xml and download dat. So it maintains the information about the activity of the user in the forms of various files Okay, so in the earlier web browsers, that is Firefox, Google Chrome and the Vivaldi, we discussed that the information is maintained in the database like places.sqlite or history.sqlite. But in case of Opera web browser, the information is maintained in the text file. So like global_history.dat, it is a text file, and this the information which are represented in the global_history.dat file is in the three fields like a title, URL, date and time. That means what is the title of that particular website or web page is URL, and the date and time at which that particular web page or the website have been accessed, so that is maintained in the global_history.txt file. search_field_history.dat, so this is an XML file and it contains the history of queries that have been made by the user in the search bar of the web browser. So whenever we want to search something onto the internet, so we are placing something, we are typing something in the text bar, search bar of the web browser. So certainly that information is maintained in this table, that is a search_field_history.dat. Then we are having the typed_history.xml file. This also is an XML file and it contains the history of the URLs typed in the address bar of the web browsers. Okay, so here we are having the details of the URLs that have been that have been visited by the users, and download that certainly it maintains the number of files which have been downloaded by the user while using this particular web browser, that is Opera. Now certainly it is not just the case that a particular user who had accessed this particular web browsers like Google Chrome, Opera, Vivaldi and the Firefox. So if he is an expert, he or she is an expert user, they knows that that some information, if they are accessing on the internet, so the details of their activities maintained in the log files. So those who are the expert user, okay, so they certainly deletes or clear the history from the web browser. So certainly in that case there is a need of protections of the particular information in that log files. Okay, so that is some of the kind of a drawbacks of this particular the log files which are created onto the hard disk. There is no security or protection have been provided to those log files. So anytime the particular user who is accessing this particular web browser, so they can easily clear the history. In that case, some strict protection or the security is required to be provided to the particular log files associated with the web browser. So in that case, it will be very much easy, or the task of the forensic investigator will become quite easy to gather the evidence about the user activity on the web browsers. Okay, that means user activity on the internet while using the web browser. So it will be easier task for the digital forensic investigator to gather the evidence from the log files. Now what kind of user's activity can be performed by the user while using the web browser? So we can categorize the activity of the users, okay, while using the web browsers, like a website browse, sending and receiving mail and uploading and downloading of the document. So the what are the user activity that can be performed by the user while using the web browser can be broadly categorized like this, like a website browse, sending and receiving mail and the uploading and downloading of the document. So the website, so where we can find out the details about the website browse. So far in the previous slides we discussed about the database like places.sqlite, history.sqlite. So those database maintain the details about the URLs which have been visited by a particular user. So from that one can understand, also the cookies also provide the information about the URLs which have been visited. So that means the cookies are downloaded associated with a website, which are associated with a particular website. So certainly the cookies are going to maintain the URLs for that particular website for which it is associated. So even from the cookies also we can get, even from the cache directory also can provide the information about the particular URLs. So it maintains the file, that means websites. Okay, so whatever the files are there, the web pages or the websites, so that are maintained in the cache directory. So it maintains also the URL. So from there we can get the website browse. Then the sending and receiving mail. So for that purpose also we are required to analyze the URL. Okay, what are the URLs have been visited? So that is maintained in the log files of the various web browsers. So the forensic investigator is required to analyze those particular log files. Okay, associated with the various email service provider, obtain the various URL that we can have for sending and the receiving mail on the Linux-based computer system. So we can have the email service provider like a Yahoo Mail, Gmail, Redmail, and the Yandex. So these are some of the email service provider. Now associated with the Yahoo Mail, whenever you are trying to compose some kind of a mail, that means suppose some malicious user is there and he is trying to compose some mail, that means trying to send some mail to some his extra handler. So in that case we can come to that means we can check whether he has actually compiled or composed some mail or not. So that can be obtained from the URL. Like here, associated with the Yahoo Mail, we can see that there is a compose word. Whenever you open that compose section of the particular email service, so it shows that compose. We are in that compose section. Similarly, Gmail, whenever trying to send or receive the mail, sending the mail by the Gmail, then certainly we are using the compose. We have to go to the inbox. Suppose if we are going, if you are writing a reply to a particular mail, so certainly you have to open the inbox and then you have to give the reply to that. So in this particular example of the URL for the Gmail, you can see that there is the inbox and also the compose. So certainly from both the words you can see that the particular user has opened the inbox, but the email he has read, and then he has written back the reply to the his sender. Then the Redmail, whenever you are using the Redmail, actually you can get a lot of detail from the Redmail URL, related URL. Like here you can see that the login IDs, if you capture the Redmail URLs from the log files, so you can get a lot of details about the particular user's activity on the web browsers while using the Redmail email service. So from here we can get the login details. Like here you can see that Dinesh underscore 27675 or something you are having. So that is the login ID. Actually, that is one related to mine. I have done the experimentation and I obtained these particular details. And like some files which have been attached, so that also we can see, like d.txt.attach. That means this particular file is attached to this mail. Okay, and this mail is being composed. So these details is maintained in the URL also for the particular Redmail server service provider. Yandex is another kind of a email service provider, and from there we can get the login details. If a particular user is trying to compose some mail and trying to send some mail to some is another person, so that details we can know that whether that particular person has actually composed some mail or not, and which login ID he have used for that purpose, so that we can get from the URL associated with the Yandex email service provider. Then we can have the another kind of activity, that is uploading and downloading of the document. Certainly the downloading information is maintained in the download historical log files. So we can have the download database. In that particular download tables of the various historical files, you can maintain the list of the files or the particular program which have been downloaded at your system from the remote web server location is maintained in those particular download section, particular tables. So that details we can get from those tables. Similarly, what files have been uploaded on the email? Okay, maybe suddenly you are using you are trying to send some sensitive document. Suppose a malicious insider is there and is trying to send some sensitive document to the his handler. So in that case, how we can check? Like as I said, that whenever you are using the Redmail, So if you observe the URL of the Rediffmail, so you can get the ideas of what kind of files have been attached to your mail. Like here let's say the list of the files which have been attached, like d.txt is the file which have been attached, so that we can get that information from here, and the mail was being composed. So the uploading related information also we can get. Okay, so that means if a particular malicious insider is there and is trying to attach some malicious sensitive file or to his mail, so that details also we can get from the URL associated with that email service provider. So that's why the forensic investigator is required to identify the evidence related to these kinds of activity to understand whether he is actually is doing some malicious activities on the system or not. So let's say if you talk about a website browse, so from that also the forensic investigator can understand whether he's a malicious insider or not. That means prospective malicious insider. Certainly, if a particular malicious website have been visited by the user while using some web browser, so in that case, what is the purpose of visiting those website? And suppose from those particular malicious website, some malicious software have been downloaded. So that information we can get from the download tables. So in that case, we can come to the conclusion that this particular person is doing some kind of a suspicious activities. So that's why this historical log files analysis is important for the digital forensic investigator. Now, what kind of tools are there to assist the digital forensic investigator in order to do the log file analysis of the various web browser on the Linux based computer system? Now, Autopsy is a kind of a complete digital forensic platform, and it is being used on the, it can be installed on the Windows also and the Linux operating system. So what kind of information are extracted by the Autopsy? It extracts the web history, cookies, bookmarks, and those are extracted from the Firefox, Chrome and the Internet Explorer web browsers. Then DEFT, that is a digital evidence forensic toolkit. This is a complete toolkit set, and it supports the extracting the forensic evidence from the IE and the Firefox web browser. IE means Internet Explorer. Then the Pasco and Galata, this particular tool examines the cookies files on the Internet Explorer. Suppose if you are using the Internet Explorer, and suppose some cookies are downloaded or associated with the website, so that we can examine by using the Galata tool. And these tools, Pasco and Galata, runs on the Windows, Linux, Mac OS and the BSD platforms. Then the forensic toolkit, it supports the forensic analysis of Internet Explorer, Firefox, Chrome, Safari and Opera web browsers, and that have been there on the Windows platform. That means we can perform the forensic investigation of these particular web browsers which are installed on the Windows based computer system. Then there is a browser history examiner. This particular tool, from the name itself we can understand that it is going to perform the it is going to analyze the web history for the Chrome, Firefox, Internet Explorer on the Windows platform. That means it is also meant for the Windows operating system. InCase is again a kind of a complete forensic toolkit, but it also supports the forensic investigations of the web browser history, cookies and cache file for the Internet Explorer, Firefox, Chrome, Opera and Safari web browser also, and that too on the Windows platform. Then web forensic analyzer, so this particular is a tool which supports the web browsers such as Internet Explorer, Mozilla Firefox, Safari, Opera, Chrome, Swing, Komodo Dragon, and it also runs on the Windows platform. So among these tools, that means some tools are meant for the Windows based computer system and some are meant for the Linux based computer system. So we'll see how to extract the evidence from the various log files of the multiple web browsers by using the terminal of the Linux operating system. So a practical demonstration of extracting the evidence, we'll see on the terminal of the Linux operating system. So in order to open the terminal, we have to press simultaneously Ctrl Alt plus T on the keyboard, so which is going to open the terminal. So on the terminal we can use the various commands in order to extract the evidence from the various log files of the multiple web browsers. See, in this particular video so far we have seen that the Firefox, that means where the evidence of the particular web browsers like Firefox, Google Chrome, Opera and Vivaldi are located, and that means the prospective locations of the multiple web browsers are, and that means we have discussed that particular locations of those log files. So in the on the screen you are able to see the terminal of the Linux operating system. Now on this particular terminal we can use the various commands in order to extract the evidence from the various log files. So the we discuss so far in this particular video about the Mozilla Firefox, Google Chrome, Opera and the Vivaldi web browsers, so, and the prospective locations of those particular web browser of the, that means the log files of the particular web browsers where they are available, and what kind of evidence we can extract from the log files of those particular multiple web browsers. So that we discuss. Now we'll see how to extract the evidence from those particular web browsers log files. So for that purpose already I have created the commands, and I copied those command onto certain files. Okay, so in the text editor you can see that the particular commands for various web browsers are seen. So like the first command that is visible to you on the screen is for extracting the evidence from the Mozilla Firefox, the historical related details. Okay, that means history means whatever the URLs that have been visited by the particular user using the Mozilla Firefox, so that is available in that is available in the places.sqlite database. In the places.sqlite database, one of the table is there which is called as moz_history_visits. Now we have to copy that particular command and paste it over in this particular on the terminal. So now just I was discussing about this particular command. So moz_history_visits is the table under the places.sqlite database. From this particular moz_history_visits table, the information about the URL which have been visited by the user of the Mozilla Firefox web browser are retrieved, and those evidence are displayed in a ascending order, so as per the date. So whenever particular user visit a particular web site, in what order that have been visited, so that particular order is arranged in the ascending order, that means they are as per the date. Okay, so whenever a particular visit a particular website, its date is also recorded in the moz_history_visits table along with the URL name. So along from that particular information in the history visits table, the information are extracted and they are shown in the ascending order as per the date on which the particular website was visited by the user. So on clicking this particular command, so for that purpose we are required to use the SQLite3 command. Now if you see that SQLite3 command is using the particular path of the places.sqlite database. So this particular places.sqlite database is available in a particular directory. So on clicking this particular command, will be able to see this kind of a result which is being displayed on the terminal. So now the various the log files which are being extracted from the Mozilla Firefox log file which is associated with the various historical data, such as the historical file URL visited, the cookies visited or downloaded, URLs that is something cache related file, cache related data, then the downloads related data, so we can extract from those log files. So as I was discussing about this particular path for the places.sqlite database, it is residing in a particular directory, that is home. Then under the name of the user .mozilla firefox, a directory is created, under that firefox and the name of the another subdirectory, that is 869ue2kw.default-release. Now this particular directory will be different on the different terminal. Now we can copy the result of the command in another particular file. Okay, so what are the particular the result that we got earlier on? So this particular result, it can be displayed on some another particular file. So how we can get that particular information? By using the particular greater than symbol. Okay, and the name of the file. So like the result.txt is the name of that particular file which was where the result was displayed, like xyz.txt, where we got this particular result. Okay, so by using the vi editor, we can open that particular text file. Okay, so that means instead of displaying on the terminal, it is possible to display the particular result in a text file itself directly. So by using the greater than symbol and the name of the file in front of the particular command, we can copy the, we can edit or write the result of the particular command onto some file, and then we can edit that particular file by using the vi editor, or we can open the particular file by using the vi editor. Now another command, in order to access the cookies which have been downloaded whenever we are visiting a particular website, so those details are available, we can extract from the this command. So the information about that is going to be available in the cookies.sqlite database. Okay, and for that purpose, this particular cookies.sqlite database maintain a particular table call as moj underscore cookies. So that is available, we can see that in the particular table, that is moj underscore cookies, the information about the URLs for which this particular cookie is associated, that means for whatever the website have been downloaded and along with that the cookies are coming. So for a particular website, whenever cookie is downloaded, so that entry will be made into the cookies moj underscore cookies table that falls under the cookies.sqlite. Now here something went wrong, that is we are required to specify the double quotes. So double quotes must be placed, so this information will get, that means whatever the websites are there and for those particular website what the cookies have been downloaded, like for youtube.com, google.com, then some techmint.com. So for those particular websites, the cookies have been downloaded on those particular dates. So that is being specified in the result. So we can display this particular result on the particular some another, or we can store the result in some another text file as well. So that is also possible with this. Now what are the contents in this particular directory, that is 869ue2kw, so that we can see in this particular. So how we can go to that particular directory? So for that purpose, you have to type cd, that is change directory. Okay, on the terminal you have to use the command change directory. So now we are in that particular directory of the Mozilla Firefox, and then 869ue2kw.default-release. Now once we click on the directory, okay, on the command, that is dir, we'll be able to see what are the contents in that directory. So you can see that so many information like a block list, what are, suppose if you download some websites you are blocked, so that you can have in the XML file that is named as blocklist.xml, cookies.sqlite, if you are the cookies related information is available there, then we can have places.sqlite. You already seen the use of the places.sqlite in retrieving the URL information and some other related information, some web while using the web browser, that is Mozilla Firefox. So that information is available or maintained in the various the log files of the Mozilla Firefox, and these are the listing of the various log files, right? Now we want to come out of this particular directory of the Mozilla. So for that purpose, we have to use the command cd backslash. So we'll come out of that particular directory and we'll be at the root directory. Now the next is about how to extract the cache. Okay, so for that purpose, we have to use the find. Okay, one of the command, and to this particular command, we have to give the information that is about the path of that particular cache directory where it is available. Okay, so on copying this particular find, that means command, and at the terminal, we'll be able to see what kinds of cache, that means website related cache, are downloaded. Okay, in the cache directory, so that we'll be able to see. Just we'll copy this. So directly the terminal does not provide the control V kind of options, so we have to use the edit and paste. So now what are the information that is available, and that means web page which are maintained in the cache, so that we'll be able to see from this particular command, that is find, then dot cache slash Mozilla Firefox. So the before the find, the symbol that is coming after the find is a tilde symbol, tilde slash dot cache. Okay, so these are the various cache which are available. So if you click on that particular command, we'll be able to see what are the entries that have been made in the cache directory, so that we can see. Now we can copy this particular same information in some of the file as well. Same way for what are the downloads related operation that have been performed by using the Mozilla Firefox, so that will be available in the downloads directory, so that we can get from using the find command itself. So just we'll copy this command and we'll paste it on the terminal. So we can click on edit and paste. So these are the files which have been downloaded. Okay, so once you click enter this particular find tilde slash download, so the downloads related and the directory will open, download directory will open, and what are the files they are that are there in the downloads directory will be visible to us on the terminal. So these kinds of operation we can perform with the Mozilla Firefox on the terminal. That means it's like we are doing the extracting the evidence directly from the terminal. Now another web browser is a Chrome. So from the Chrome itself, we can the user. So this is the command for extracting the evidence from the history log files of the Google Chrome. Just we'll copy the command here on the terminal and paste it there. So where this particular history.sqlite database is available, it is available in the dot config slash google chrome slash default and the history. Now it is in the root directory. Under the root directory, we are having the dot config directory. So we are selecting a particular all the urls. Now urls here in this command is a table that is coming under the history database. So once we click on this command, we'll get this particular, we'll get the particular result. So that is shown here for the Google Chrome, what are the information that have been website that have been accessed. So this information is available in the URLs table of the history.sqlite database. Then is about the cookies. So cookies are available in the cookies database, and that is available in the same directory, that is .config slash google chrome slash default. And in the cookies dot cookies.sql database, there is a particular table called as the cookies, and from where the details about the cookies which are downloaded at the computer by using the Google Chrome are maintained. Okay, the details of that are maintained in the cookies table. So this is what the details will get. Okay, now we click on the command. Okay, so at the bottom we can see the terminal, that is on the the command prompt, you will get will require to paste the command, and we'll see these are the cookies which have been downloaded while using the Google Chrome web browser. Okay, so that we can get. So you can see the various for various websites at what time they have been downloaded, so that time is also displayed. Same way the Chrome, Google Chrome also maintain the cache. Okay, so for the particular website which are required to be there available in the cache directory, so that is available in the cache. So a copy of that particular web page is or website is maintained in the cache directory of this Google Chrome web browser, just similar as that of the Mozilla Firefox. So the path is just varying. We have to go to the dot cache, Google Chrome default, and the cache or kind of a directory. So you have to use the command find. So by the find command will give the entire details about the what are the files which are available in the cache directory, so that we can get from the terminal itself. Just paste it there on the terminal. And just click on enter. Enter button we have to press. So we'll be getting the details about the cache. That means web pages, site that are available, a cache copy of those particular websites which are available in the cache directory of the Google Chrome. So these are the registering of the cache. What are the files or the websites which are there available in the cache directory? So this is for the Google Chrome. Same way we can use the we can extract the evidence from the Opera as well, Opera web browser. So this is the command for accessing the cookies related information from the Opera web browser log files. So these cookies are available in the .config/opera and in the cookies.sqlite database. So SQLite 3 command, whenever we are using, certainly it means that it is a cookies, it is a SQLite database. Okay, we SQLite 3 command is generally used for opening a database of the which is having the extension .sqlite. And in the cookies dot particular table, cookies.sqlite table, there is a cookies.sqlite database, there is a table called as a cookies, and these cookies maintain the details about the cookies which are downloaded while using the Opera web browser. So we'll copy this particular command on the terminal, and then we'll see the result of what about the cookies which are available in the cookies table. Okay, so these are the listing which is available in the cookies table, so that we can get. Now same way we can access the cache directory related information from the Opera web browser. Also it also maintains the cache directory under the dot cache and the Opera directory. So the way we have used the for accessing or extracting the evidence for the Firefox and the Google Chrome, same way we have to use the same command, that is find command, to extract the evidence from the cache directory. So when we enter or the execute the command on the terminal, it will show the listing of all the websites which are being cached in the cache directory. So this is what the listing of the website that have been cached in the cache directory. Then we can get the details about the downloads, that means the files which have been downloaded by using the Opera web browser. So again we have to use the command downloads. Find command is required to be used, and the path of the downloads directory we have to provide to that particular find command. So it is in the root directory, so that's why we are having the tilde symbol. Then same way we can use the Vivaldi, the extract the evidence from the Vivaldi web browser. The command for that is this one. The SQLite 3 history is the SQLite database, so we have to extract the evidence from this history.sqlite database. Under the history.sqlite there is a URLs table, and whatever the contents are there within the URLs table, we have to extract that evidence. So that will provide the details about what the URLs have been visited while using the Vivaldi web browsers. So that just we'll see for demonstration purpose. We'll copy that command and paste it on the terminal. Let's execute this. Now we'll see these are the the list of the website which have been visited by while using the Vivaldi web browsers. Now another information or a log files that we can extract is about the cookies. So what are the cookies which have been downloaded? So again here the cookies for the Vivaldi is available in this directory, in the particular path .config/vivaldi/default, and in the cookies direct database there is a table called as a cookies, and which maintains the list of the websites, okay, for which the cookies are downloaded. So that we details we can get from the this particular command. Let's copy this and on the terminal just execute it, so we'll be able to see the cookies, that means for the website which for which these cookies are downloaded. So this is the listing of the particular web page websites for which the cookies are downloaded. So we can get the date and the time and also the name of the particular website which have been visited. Now what is the contents within this particular default directory, okay, of the Vivaldi web browser, so that we'll see what kind of log files are maintained. So same command we can use for the previous web browser that we have seen, like Opera, Google Chrome, in order to know what are the information or the log files which are available in their directory of those web browsers. So this is the listing of all the log files which are maintained for the Vivaldi web browser. So you can see various information is there, like cookies, already just we have seen that, history and other kind of information. So we have to come out of that particular directory, and just we will see some another command for reading the cache related data from the cache directory of the Vivaldi web browsers. So this is the particular path, that is .cache/vivaldi/default/cache. So where the cache related cache web pages, what are the websites or the web pages that have been cached on the hard disk, so it is going to be maintained in that directory. So by using these particular various commands, okay, on the terminal, we are able to extract the evidence from the log files of these web browsers like Firefox, Google Chrome, Opera and the Vivaldi. So that is possible by using these commands. So apart from we can visit directly to the particular location as well. Okay, so it is possible that we can directly visit to the particular location. So far we have seen that how we can extract the forensic evidence from the log files of the various web browsers. Now in order to extract the evidence from the various web browsers, I created a particular tool using which the various evidence from the various log files can be extracted. So for that purpose I have used a particular tool called as a Qt creator, and by using the Qt creator I created a tool named as libfo, by that is for the Linux web browser forensics. So this is the view of the particular Qt creator, and where the project is available in this tool_version.directory. So under this it is going to have the various directory like headers, sources. In the sources directory it is having one of the important file, that is the tool.cpp, which is having the coding for various purposes for extracting the evidence from the log files of the various web browsers on the Linux based computer system. Then apart from that, this tool.cpp, there are others file like a button.cpp which are responsible for creating the buttons. Then button.header files, main window.header file and tool.header file. So those files are required for the execution for this particular source file, which are required to be included in those source file. Now this program is a particular project is required to be built. So for that purpose, click on the build option, build the project, Now on the bottom right corner, you can see the build process is going on. So if there are no errors, so then we can go and execute the program. So for that, click on the build and then go and run. So now you will be able to see this kind of the user interface for the tool. So from this, you can see that the name of the tool is Live4, that is for Linux Web Browser Forensics. So in this, the options for various web browser, that is Firefox, Google Chrome, Opera and the Vivaldi's are provided. So for each particular web browsers, the historical details such as history, URLs visited, cookies, downloaded, cache and the download. So those are available. That means we can extract the evidence related to those historical files. So in order to extract a particular evidence from the particular web browser, check the box. Let's say I have checked the Firefox box, then click on the particular buttons like history, cookie, cache or the downloads, then that particular result will be shown in this particular window, okay, in this particular dialog text, or in a big, that is also can consider as a text box. So we'll see the demonstration how the information are extracted for every activity, that means for every that means log files. So I clicked on the history file, so you can see that, or the download files, you can see that what are the files which are downloaded by using the Firefox web browsers. So you can select a particular evidence, and that particular evidence we can place on the right side of the text of this particular as part of extracted evidence. Then you can say the Google Chrome, if you take that, you can see what are the cookies which are downloaded by the Google, for the Google Chrome, when using the Google Chrome web browsers. So that we can see here. So we can select, drag and drop a particular evidence which we feel important. So these are the cookies which are downloaded for this Google Chrome. When using the Google Chrome web browsers, we also can select, drag and drop. So the particular facility have been provided for the forensic investigator to do the select the evidence manually. So the cache, what are the files, the web pages which are stored in the cache directory. So that details also we can extract from the cache directory. So the forensic investigator can also drag and drop a particular evidence from the this cache directory like this. Then we can see what are the downloads that have been achieved. That means what are the files which have been downloaded while using the Google Chrome web browser. So that also we can see. Same way we can do for the Opera web browsers. So what are the cookies that have been downloaded, like for particular web site that have been accessed, so that we can see cache, what are the files, the web pages that have been stored there in the cache directory. So that is available here, the listing of that, so that we can see. Then the downloads, same way we can do the for the Vivaldi web browsers also, is history files. Okay, so these are the web pages which have been visited when using the Vivaldi, so that is available there. So we can drag and drop evidence. Then cookies which have been downloaded for a particular website, so that also we can get. Cache files, cache that means web pages, so for the Vivaldi web browsers, so that is dragged and drop. So that means for all these facility have been provided, that the forensic investigator can do a drag and drop, so that he can select a particular evidence of importance, of forensic importance. So that have been provided in this particular tool. So the main facility is that we are doing the multiple web browser. Now whatever the extracted evidence are there, from that we can generate a report. So for that purpose, you have to click on the file and the generate report. So that is going to be stored in a particular directory. So that path is provided here in this. So this is the forensic report. So whatever the evidence that I have tracked and dropped on the forensic evidence part, extracted evidence part, so the same is created there. So that means the forensic investigator is having the particular facility have been provided so that it can create a kind of a report on the text file. So that can be created by using this Linux web browser forensic tool. It's a not a complete tool, it's a just a prototype kind of a tool. Okay, so many features are required to be included this. So just for the demonstrative purpose, I created this particular tool by using which we can extract the evidence from the various log files of the multiple web browsers which are installed on the Linux based computer system. So this particular tool extract the evidence for the Firefox web browser, Google Chrome web browser, and the Opera and the Vivaldi web browsers. Thanks for watching this particular video. If you like this particular video, please click on the subscriber button to get the notification for the future videos on the digital forensics. Thank you.